Do you know the differences between an ACX7024 and a 7024X?
X?
If you give me 5 minutes, I will tell you everything. Let's start with a quick overview of the ACX7024. It's an Ethernet router that has been released in mid-2022. One IU, a pizza box, offering a mix of 24 SFP interfaces and 4 ports QSFP28 for 100 gigabit Ethernet. It's a hardened device, categorized as high temp. That means it supports temperatures from minus 40 to plus 65 Celsius. The forwarding is handled by a QMRAM 2U ASIC, and that can push your packet at 360 gigabits per second. For timing, it contains a specialized PTP FPGA developed by Juniper Networks, offering up to Class D clock quality. In the front, the router presents field-replaceable AC or DC power modules. On the back, we see 6 fixed fans. It's a front-to-back cooling. One last word on ACX7024. The architecture is very simple, with SFP and QSFP optical cages directly connected to the packet forwarding engines, without any intermediate PHY. A MUX is used to interconnect the PTP FPGA, if you configure timing, at the expense of the port 27. And finally, we have an Intel Atom Devron CPU with 16 gigabytes of DRAM. And this CPU and DRAM are the key differences between ACX7024 and ACX7024X. The 24 non-X has been designed for metro and aggregation roles. In this position, no need for advanced features or even a full internet table. It needs to be optimized at every level, including the cost. That implies trading off certain features like sampling, IPFix, and FIB compression for large routing tables. The port density and form factor happens to be very attractive for other use cases, particularly enterprise categories. We can talk about light multi-service edge router here. Hardware hardening and high temp support is not required for such roles. But in the other end, we expect to support the features like sampling and potentially full V4 and V6 internet tables. That's the motivations behind the release of an ACX7024X that only differs from its predecessor at the CPU and DRAM level. Same port density and forwarding capability, same ASIC, but a more powerful CPU with 8 core at 2.4 GHz and 64 GB of memory. With this new control plane, we can operate now in commercial C-temp environments. On ACX7024X, we support 4 different MDB profiles. If you are not familiar with this concept of MDB profile, I invite you to watch this video, or here. By default, it will boot up in lineage mode, and in this example here, we have a full internet view received from an eBGP peer. That's almost 1 million V4 entries and more than 200,000 V6. In my lab, it's of course an ideal case, since I have a single BGP neighbor. But still, you can see the compression in action, with a ratio of 83% for V4 and 73% for V6. To avoid any confusion, that means we reduced more than 5 times the V4 table and almost 4 times the V6. It's a pretty efficient mechanism. In terms of resource occupation, that's my app ID 12 here, with 212k V4 and 66k V6 entries. Total 346k used out of the 1.2 million capacity. So we have plenty of room to grow. And to conclude this quick overview of the new router, the ACX7024X is a very affordable 360 gig router with 24 ports SFP, 1 gig, 10 or 25 gig, and 4 ports QSFP, 40 or 100 gigabit Ethernet. PTP Class D capable and with a large DRAM space for CPU intensive features. If you need more details, take a look at the TechPost article coming with this video. And of course, don't hesitate to contact us if you have any questions. See you in the next one.